A True G Story.
A movie. I'm in the bed with a tule. Bad wood, feel fruity. She like the way that I'm moving. Like 70 years, a young nigga pulling the tug of war. You know, I'm having pull like a fish out the line, the bitch out the roof. She don't want my time, she just want my book. It's love for the judge and the DA too. We finna shoot us a movie. I'm in the bed with the tule. Bad wood, feel fruity. She like the way that I'm moving. Like 70 years, a young nigga groovy. Tug of war, you know, I'm having pull like a fish out the line, the bitch out the roof. She don't want my time, she just want my book. It's love for the judge and the DA too.
Shakur and Tank, that's the fight that everybody talking about, Shakur and Tank.
I got 50-50, but I still, no, I will give Tank a 10% edge on him, man, 60-40.
Because of the power?
Yeah, because of the power, you know what I'm saying? I want to see how he deal with it, if he has to be there. We all know Shakur can move, right? So he can stay away from danger, but when he gotta be in the mix and Tank gonna bring it to him, you know, I'm gonna see how he gotta deal with that power. When he get touched, not once but two or three times, bro, throughout the fight, bro, I wanna see how he gonna react to it. And I don't think he stands up to it, man. I think he takes the first few blows, but if he get caught clean too much, man, I see Tank, I see Tank ending it. But he's good enough to box Tank for 12 rounds. If it go 12, I can see Shakur winning.
We be throwing money in a spiral. Every time your girl hear my song, yeah, turn her right into my hole.
That's why I like Tank. He's an aggressive dude, he's a mean dude.
The youngest star of boxing and popular pound for pound great. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the hard hitting and renowned 5-time 3-weight division world champion and the current undefeated reigning and defending WBA lightweight champion of the world, introducing Gervonta.
Don't blink, because this shit can be over early. All those guys are good fighters, but none of them can fuck with Tank. None of them. None of them.
You think that's going to be your hardest fight?
Hell no.
Nah?
Why?
Because he a good boxer, nigga. Like, that's one way I look at Chatsu as the best in the division.
How? Show me something that he did spectacular. Show me something that he did outrageous. Show me.
Right,
his power not outrageous.
Okay.
His what defense? You never see him slip no punch. You never see him slip no punch. Mm. Go look at it. You see him back up from a lot of people. Back up, move around. He don't got no technique. And his offense is the same thing.
Mm.
Go look at his fights.
So you
I
feel
probably
like
pin him on
work.
Game by the time.
Yeah, hold on, but you feel like it's easy work though. You like,
come on, bro.
Yeah.
Bro, I touched him with 16 ounce gloves on.
Mm.
And he ran. Imagine if I hit him with 8 ounces.
Come on now, nigga. Like, you saying you want to fight me, but is you really going to fight me? Or are you going to just keep saying what you going to do to somebody or talking about it, bro? Shut up and fight me, nigga.
In reality, I'm 5'4. Stand on my money now, I'm 6'6. Hit her once, now she dismissed. Can't fuck her sister, make her leak dick.
I'm going to show him. I'm going to show everybody. I'm going to show all these fighters that I'm the best fighter at 135 pounds by far.
The reason that we're saying it's a 50-50 fight is because it's such a competitive matchup. And we have style differences the way that we have in this fight in particular. It leaves a lot of room for interpretation and questioning.
The biggest puncher I feel at the 135 would probably be Gervonta Tank Davis. But the most skillful fighter at 135 would be hands down Shakur Stevens.
Yes, he beats Tank. He outboxes him.
very easy. No problem whatsoever.
Shakur is the best. He's better than Tank. He's better than Devin. He's better than Ryan. He's better than T.C.
That dude get to feeling himself and feeling like he's something that he's not. And to the world, he look like a killer, but I can't wait. I'm going to expose him. I promise you, I'm going to expose him. Right? I'm going to be the person to, that he going there. He's not going to knock out. He's not going to hurt. He got to go 12 rounds with somebody, and somebody going to be beating him.
When the fight does happen, one thing I can tell everybody, it's going to be fireworks. It's going to be action. It's going to be packed. You better get your tickets early. Get your hotel rooms early. You better get your, matter of fact, order your rental cars early. It's one of them kind of fights. Whatever city or wherever I know it's gonna be at, it's gonna be a major event. I know it.
That's a great fight. You know, I think that's 50-50. You know, they two great guys, two sharp guys, and that's a great fight. You know?
Feel like, is it 50-50? Like, you feel like
it,
that?
No,
or is it political boobs giving me, or you feel like it's really 50-50?
No, I really think it's 50-50. You know, they both great fighters, though. Yeah. Like we not going to know until they get in the ring.
For sure.
You know,
sure.
I can say all I want. It don't really matter.
Yeah.
But I think it's a 50-50 fight. You know?
I think so, too.
That's a great match. You know, Shakur is sharp. You know, he know how to box. He's technical. You know, Tank, you know, he's sharp. He box. He
power.
He box. Mm-hmm. He can do everything, too. So, I don't know. I think that's going to make up for a great fight. You know, I think that's going to be a sharp, technical fight.
Javante Tank Davis by TKO or KO. I mean, I love both of those guys. You know, I love the style of Shakur. Even though everybody's trying to say Bond, I love the style of Shakur. He's a great boxer. But Tank is a killer.
Y'all know me. I'm dangerous.
Tank, at this point, he's unbeatable at the lightweight division against any of the world champions. I think he's the top guy right now at that division. He has his timing, his power, accuracy, everything's great, man. He's the perfect fighter.
That's the fight boxing needs. That's the fight that should be made. Tank Shakur. Not Tank Lomachenko, not Tank Haney, not Tank Shakur Stevenson, in my opinion, is the fight that should be made for boxing right now.
That's a tough fight, man. It's a chess match, to say the least. You got power and you got technique. You got a guy that got some of the best feet in the game, and you got a guy like Javante that his energy is unmatched in the ring. When I look at that fight, I don't see Shakur moving enough to avoid Tank Davis all night. I think Tank IQ in the ring allow him to cut the ring off and get to Shakur, unless Shakur is on his bicycle, and that's it. And I don't think he'll make a fight like that and just run all night. I think he'll be forced to fight and probably show you a Shakur Stevenson that none of us thought he could be in a fight like that.
Man, that's just a fight where it's two undefeated fighters, two champions. Shakur got that style where it's hard to hit, but Tank is crafty. He has power. So it's a matter of power versus, I guess you would say, speed, even though Tank has speed, but Shakur just has that slick movement where it's hard to, it'd make it a little difficult for Tank to set that power up. But Tank is a special fighter. He's proven himself to be a special fighter. Shakur, he's right there. But every time is that opportunity for him to, like, shine, he puts a performance where people are not enjoying it. Now, a boxing fan like me, I get what he's doing and I could appreciate it. But as far as the average boxing fan, they want to be entertained. They want to see what Tank's doing, and Tank's giving them knockouts. And Shakur is just making guys miss and he's making them pay, which is the name of the game. But this is the entertainment business. People want to see more action. I think Shakur needs to take a page from Mayweather when he was Pretty Boy Floyd. He had the skills and the ability to make you miss, but he made you pay and he knocked you out and he took you out of there. So it's just a matter Shakur making that adjustment where he can start getting guys out.
People is blessed with different abilities. He's blessed with a God-given ability that he crack you, 9 times out of 10, you're gonna go down. That's his ability. I'm blessed with God-given eyes. Mm. My eyes is amazing.
Yeah.
A lot of people don't understand how good my eyes is. I can see really good. Like, punches coming my way, I know how to get away from them.
Right.
At any given time. Our abilities are just different, so they probably are judging me from a scale of him, but at the end of the day, he's a great fighter. He's a special fighter. I can't take nothing away from him, but
yeah.
I'm special in my own right, too. It's a part of my game. I think when we need to do that to get the job done, that's what we do. We will do. If we need to do this to get the job done, that's what we do. I think that I'm that type of fighter that I'm going to do whatever it takes to get the job done that night. His style is his style. My style is my style. And when we clash, it's going to come who has the better style that night. And that's all that it's going to come down to. Can he land a big shot? Because he can't give up 100 rounds with somebody like me and expect to still win the fight. I'm not that guy. I'm not just gonna be sitting there letting no nigga punch on me in no type of situation.
There's tons of things to discuss, but at the end of the day, it's whoever's gonna enact their own game plan on fight night. Tank Davis generally starts very slow because he's analyzing data. He has a very high boxing IQ. He's a good boxer himself, but he takes time to figure guys out, get their timing, get their rhythm. He's a shorter guy. He's got to close that distance. He's got to be smart about it. And especially if the guy has a little bit of pop and or has good distance control the way that Shakur does. Shakur's really good at making you miss, making you reach, making you pay for it, and then shifting off without getting touched. That's a very difficult guy to deal with for 12 rounds. But it, once again, even when Tank falls behind, he has that great eraser. He's got that shot. So for all 12 rounds, Shakur has to be completely focused and locked in. This exactly why this is considered a 50-50 fight, if you're looking at it that way, is because of all these points. You got guys that have very different styles, but they both have mastered the style that they prefer, and then it's going to come down to fight night, who can enact said style and make the other guy fight their fight.
Either way, I like the talk, but I want to see the fight. Let's get the fight made. This is what we're talking about here. We want to keep talking and talking. Let's make the fight already.
I'm saying, though, like, how many times he got to say he going to fight an elite fighter and never fight him? He 30 years old now. Like, what we talking about? Like, bro, 30, talking about he going to fight me. Yo, when you going to fight me? He say next. Okay. Well, then do it, nigga. I'm right here. All you got to do is send an offer. Reach out, nigga. There's nothing stopping it, bro. You the A side I know. I'm not saying that I'm the A side. You the nigga with all the notoriety, all the however it go. I'm right here, though. I'm not going nowhere. Soon as you say, let's fight, I'm right here. Let's fight. But he'll tell y'all 100 times, oh, I want to fight this person. I'm going to beat your ass next. I'm going to do this to you and send out threats and all that shit. But it's like, come on now, nigga.
He is ass. He is ass.
When I was 8, I was rhyming that backyard game plan. Watching Snoop anxiously, you're waiting for my chance, man. Hot and cocky with it, cause I know that I am, man. I'm going down in history like American Bandstand. I stay fresh to death like the neighborhood dope man. I stay on the top cause I keep coming with dope man. You steady watching stealing, but there ain't no hope, man. You dealing with something bigger than the U.S. Open. It ain't no joking. Fresh like fat laces and Duke and Roseanne. I keep on smoking. Young but I'm ready, so that means I'm stroking. If you pet me nowadays, girl, a dog is poking. Addicted to it, JD, say I got it bad. 18, nigga, making more than your dad, see? They think they doing it, but I'ma outdo them. If you know somebody like that, pull up and say to them.
You ain't ride, you ain't ride, you ain't bumping like I'm bumping. You ain't saying nothing, homie, you ain't fresh as I mean. You ain't got it, you ain't got it. You don't keep it dug it like I keep it dug it, little buddy. You ain't fresh as I mean.
You ain't big, big whipping, you ain't steady tip tipping. No girl kicking, homie, you ain't fresh as I mean. Think you is, but you ain't. Think you got it crumped like me, but you ain't.